I am honored to be in your home today to share with you Vinyasa Yoga Flow. A yoga class is never just a half an hour long. This will be a half an hour long. So please brick it with what is recorded already on YouTube for the warm-up of a yoga class or the floor work, which is the ending component. I will start with a quick warm-up and move you through some postures and then end with a final meditation. So join me. So starting in Tadasana, with your feet hip width apart, just lengthening your spine and closing your eyes and just feeling your breath, breathing in and out. Feel your chest rising and falling. Begin with your next inhale to bring your arms overhead and reach. And with your exhale to come down. Create your own flow using your breath to go with your movement. Maybe beginning to have your breath a little deeper and a little longer. On your next inhale, sitting back in your Utkatasana, chair pose. Staying here and breathing, putting weight on your heels, lengthening your spine from your tailbone to your head, reaching through your arms. Take a breath here. And with an exhale, forward fold. Knees are soft, and then inhale, lengthen your spine and your legs. Exhale, move back into Utkatasana. Inhale, reaching up and stretching. Exhale, coming back to Utkatasana. Take a breath here. And exhale, folding over. Inhale, lengthening your spine. Exhale, moving back into Utkatasana. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, Utkatasana. Inhale, folding over and reaching. Exhale, Utkatasana. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, Utkatasana. Inhale, reaching back and stretching. Exhale, Utkatasana. Inhale, reaching up. Swinging forward and back. Now through that motion, just dropping and relaxing and then stretching. A big exhale and inhale. Release any tension that you have. Just feel that weight relaxing and going down and then stretching. Breathe with it, use your breath. Finishing up the last one. Bring your hands to heart center and hands by your side. Stepping to the front part of your mat for a couple of sun salutations. Inhale, take a deep breath in. And exhale, swan dive over. Inhale, stepping back with that left foot. Exhale, find your dog. Inhale, coming into a plank, knees or toes. Finding your child's pose. Child's pose always being an option. And then move back into your dog. Reaching your left toes high. Bring the knee into the chest. And then stepping forward with your right. Inhale, lengthen your spine. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reach out and up. Exhale, hands to your heart. Tadasana. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, swan dive over. Inhale, stepping back with your right leg. Lift your chest. Moving into dog. staying in dog, going into child's pose, or coming into a plank, lowering your knees and dropping your chest, moving into mini cobra, coming to your hands and knees, sitting back into child's pose, moving into dog. Reach your right toes high. Bring the knee into the chest as you place the foot between the hand, lengthen your spine. Stepping forward with your left foot, inhale, lengthen. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reach out and up. Exhale, prayer. Tadasana, take a breath. Inhale, deep breath in. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale, stepping back with that left foot, lengthen your spine. Exhale, find your dog. Staying in dog or child's pose, or moving into a plank. Take a breath here. Dropping your hips, open up your chest for a modified upward dog. Use your hips to pull back into downward dog. Extend those left toes high. Place that foot between your hands and lift your chest. Stepping forward with your right foot, inhale, lengthen. And exhale, fold. Inhale, reach out and up. Exhale, find in your prayer. Tadasana, taking a breath. Inhale, take a deep breath in. Exhale, swan dive over. Inhale, stepping back with that right foot. Exhale, move into dog. Staying in dog, child's pose, lowering into a plank. Chaturanga, however you want to do it. Upward dog. Downward dog. Stepping forward with your right foot. Bring that foot into your hand. Stepping forward with your left. Lengthen your spine. And forward fold. Inhale, reach out and up. Exhale to prayer. Tadasana. Take a breath. Inhale, sitting back for Utkatasana chair pose. Finding your Utkatasana, feeling the strength of your legs. Using the weight on those heels. Bringing your hands to your heart, energy between those hands. And twisting over to your right. That left elbow finding your right leg. Breathing and feeling the length of your spine with the energy of those hands together. Putting weight on that right foot and creating lightness with your left. Stepping back into upper lunge with a twist, breathing. Again, lengthen that spine a little more from your heel to the tip of your head. One more deep breath in. Circling your arms around, find Virajasana 2. Inhale, reaching up. And exhale, Virajasana 2. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, Virajasana 2. Moving with your breath. Going just a little deeper with each one. Finishing your last one and holding it there. Breathing, make little micro movements to adjust. Maybe through your hip, is your knee tracking over your foot? Squeeze your heels together to bring that inner thigh and to give you more strength. Breathe. Palms up, peaceful warrior. Exhale, lift over, right angle. Move using your breath between peaceful and right angle. holding your next right angle, reaching that arm up to the sky or to the front of the room, using the right arm on that thigh to open up that left shoulder. Breathe. Squeeze those inner thighs together. Circling that left arm around, framing your foot. I'll meet you in dog. Chaturanga, child's pose, or just going into dog. Lift your right toes high. Bring that foot in between. Engage your core and lift up to upper lunge. Bend, bring that right hip back and that left hip forward as you open up through your spine. One more deep breath in. Pushing off with that back foot, come up and bring that knee in front. Give it a hug. And bringing it down. Tadasana. Inhale, reach down and up, Utkatasana. Sitting back on those heels. Reaching through those fingertips. Bringing your palms together, energy between those hands. Twisting to your left, right hand to your left leg. Press those hands in together to get length to your spine. And breathe. Giving weight to your left foot, lightness with your right. Stepping back into upper lunge. Pull back on that right heel, lengthen your spine, and breathe. One more deep breath in. Releasing those hands and coming up to Virudrasana 2. Inhale, reach up, and exhale. Move using your breath, creating your flow. Taking each one a little further. Holding it there, going maybe just a little deeper. Engage those inner thighs, pull up through the pelvic floor. Roll your shoulders up, back, and down. Feel the strength of your legs and the length of your arms. Peaceful warrior. Moving into right angle. Move in and out using your breath. Holding your last, next right angle, using that left arm to rotate and open up that right shoulder. Breathe. Arm can be reaching up or palm facing down. Pull the shoulder into the back pocket. Circle that arm around. I'll meet you in dog. Breathe. Reach those left toes high. Bringing that foot between your hands. Engage your core and lift up to upper lunge. Pull that left hip back and that right hip forward. Open your chest. One more deep breath in. Coming up, bringing that knee up, and coming down to dasana. Inhale, reach down and up, utkatasana. Exhale, swan dive over. Inhale, lengthen as you step back with that left foot. Ground that left foot and come up into the Urdhvasana 2. Feel that Urdhvasana 2. Peaceful warrior. Straightening that front leg, lengthen from finger to toe. And lifting up, reaching forward. Straight line from one finger to the other. Using the right hand against that leg to help open up that hip, left hip. Straight line from finger to finger. Breathe. Let it feel good. One more deep breath in. Bending that right leg, take a right angle. A deeper right angle or hand on your thigh, to the mat, to a block or a bind. Breathe. One more deep breath in. Releasing your bind, bringing both hands in between your feet parallel. Lengthen your spine as you bend side to side, just stretching that inner thigh. Let it feel good. Each one going just a little lower. Finding your way to center, placing your right hand underneath your chest, long spine, soften your knees to get that long spine if you need to, reaching up and twisting with that left arm, pushing with that right arm, rotating through your core, breathe with it. One more deep breath in. Thread that left arm underneath your right to reach over to your right leg and pull back with that hand on that right shin. Reach that right arm up. Use the engagement of that left arm to rotate through the core. One more deep breath in. Bringing that right arm underneath your left. Wrap your arms to find the eagle. Thumb to the third eye. Reach towards the mat. Softening your knees. Bring your heels in and come up into goddess pose. Reaching up and down. Moving in and out. Finding a little lower, breathe. Maybe rocking side to side a little. Picking up your left toe, turn to face your right leg. Pulling those arms out and up. Open up your chest, exalted. Pushing off of that back leg, stepping up, bringing that knee into your chest, and then wrapping it over the other, maybe the toe touches the floor. Sitting back into that Utkatasana chair's pose for eagle, breathing. lowering those arms even a little more, maybe wrapping the arms on top of the knee. Releasing your hands, letting them stretch out and finding your standing split. Soften that right knee to create length with your spine and let your head fall. Bend that right knee more to find your low lunge. I'll meet you in dog. Lift those left toes high. Bring the foot between your hands. Stepping forward with your right. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, fold. Inhale, reach out and up. Exhale to prayer. Tadasana, take a breath. Inhale, reach down and up, Utkatasana. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale, stepping back with that right foot, long spine. Grounding that right foot to the mat, find Virabhadrasana 2. Peaceful warrior. Straightening that front leg, reach and stretch forward, finding your Trikonasana. Reaching up and stretching, pulling that right hip back. Aligning your spine against the wall. So the goal is to have alignment and not compromising alignment by touching the floor. Do this where it feels good for you and that you can get just a little bit more with every breath. One more deep breath in. Bending that leg, find your right angle, hand on your side, touching mat or block or binding. Half or whole. Do what works for you. Circling that arm around, bringing your feet parallel. A couple more sways side to side. It should feel good. Finding your center, left hand under your chest. Pushing with that left hand, reaching up and twisting through the core, breathing. One more deep breath in. Bringing that right arm underneath your left and reaching for your left shin. Pulling back with that left shin and then reaching up with that left arm. Breathing. Bringing that left arm underneath your right, finding your eagle. Third thumb to the third eye, pull those arms toward the mat. Softening your knees, bringing your heels in, come up into goddess pose. Lengthening your spine, tucking that tailbone under just a little, maybe going a little lower, and just gently rocking side to side. Picking your right heel up, coming to face that left leg, pulling that left hip back and that right forward, pulling those arms out and up, opening your chest. Taking one more deep breath in. Pushing off, bringing your knee up. Crossing it over your left, maybe the toe touches the floor or not. And sitting back into eagle pose. Maybe your eagle folds over those knees. Releasing your hands, finding your standing split. Soften that left knee, drop that right hip, relax your neck and head. Breathing. Soften that left leg and come into runner's lunge. I'll meet you in dog. Finding your plank, lower all the way down to the mat. Bring your hands by your side, third eye to the mat. Press your pubic bone into the mat as you lift your chest, your head, and your arms and your feet. Five long deep breaths here. One more deep breath in. Release it, turning your head to one side, turning your toes in and just wiggling your hips. Third eye, finding the mat, doing what you just did again, or reaching for your ankles. Using a strap maybe, press the ankles into the hip, into the hands as you lift up, breathing five long deep breaths. One more deep breath in. Releasing it, turning your head to the other side. Wiggling your hips. Hands finding your chest, push up onto all fours. Hands under shoulder, knees under hips. Inhale, open your chest for cow. And exhale, round your back for cat. Use your breath to create your flow. Sitting back into child's pose when you're ready. Coming into sitting or laying on your back for savasana, your choice. Get comfortable, settle in, and then just close your eyes and feel your breath. Relaxing and melting wherever you are. Long breaths. Inhale. And exhale. know that many of you are feeling anxious and uncertain with what is happening in the world today and what it means to your life. Finding hope at the core of your brain will help to give you strength, purpose, and clarity to navigate in these very challenging times. How do we find hope? Maybe start by reflecting on gratitude. What are you grateful for? What are the bright spots that are happening right now in your life? Focus on them for a minute. Starting a gratitude journal each day help you to focus on the many good things that are happening in your life and give you some inner strength and hope. As Abraham Lincoln said, the power of hope upon human exertion and happiness is wonderful. Bring the peace that you find at this moment into the rest of your day. Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. May all beings be happy, wild, and free, and may our thoughts, words, and actions contribute to their happiness. Palms together, namaste. Divine light in me honors divine light in you. Have a great day.